Good morning, my name's Tom, and I'm here today to film a little video on how to use our Rapid Rise Pressure Relay Field Test Kit, which is our Qualitrol part number KIT-013-1. The test kit, when you buy it, comes with some accessories. There's an electrical hookup with three alligator clips. There's a bag of hand tools. The wrench should be used for removing a vent on the different units. There's a spare gasket for this adapter that'll go on in the unit to help seal when we pressurize it. There's an Allen wrench for plugs. There's also a small tube of PST to be used when you replace the vent after you run the test. Basically, to start the test, you can plug in your electrical hookup. You're going to have to remove the vent from the unit. The unit can be tested on a transformer, off a transformer, any position, laying down, upright, it really doesn't matter. This bushing will get threaded into the cover. Usually hand tight is sufficient. You may have to use a pair of pliers to really tighten down on it. Okay, the next step would be to hook up this plastic tubing that will actually pressurize the top of the unit. You want to make sure you get the tubing all the way down on the bushing so there's no leaks. This happens to be a 900 unit for an oil-filled transformer, and this connector that comes with the unit. We also sell units with different configurations for Qualitrol style, ANSI, Bendix connectors. This happens to be a Qualitrol style, so I'm just going to plug my electrical hookup into that. But you can use the alligator clips on any of the pins. It'll tell you on the wiring scheme how to hook them up. Okay, as far as using the unit, the first thing you do is you push this left-hand button, and when you hold it down, the first thing you should see is two lights. What that does is it turns the power on to this test kit, and after you take your finger off the button, you should see a red light. That means that this unit is in the untripped position, so it hasn't tripped. Okay, the next step is to take this squeeze bulb, and depending on what type of unit, and there's a little chart right here on our instruction sheet that tells you what pressure to run this up to. And for a 900, it's between 3.25 and 3.5 psi, which I've reached. Once you reach that, you push the right button, and what happens is a timer comes on. It's for about 60 seconds. You have to wait 60 seconds and let the unit stabilize. Now, what this test kit does, it simulates changes in pressure in the tank. In the bottom of the unit, we have a sensing bellows that reacts to changes in pressure, increases in pressure. When the pressure goes up, there's oil inside these, what we call guts inside of this unit, and the oil goes up to the top of the unit, and there's an actuator with a switch. For low rates of rise, the switch won't trip, but for a faster rate of rise, the switch will trip. What we're doing with this test kit is we simulate a pressure increase in the bottom by actually pressurizing the top, and then we're gonna pull a valve here in a minute. We're gonna let the pressure escape out of the top really quick, and it'll simulate a sudden increase in pressure in the tank. So the timer has done its thing and it's reset. So we're back to the red light, and the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna pull a small SPRV. We're going to let the air escape. One thing to be real careful of is to make sure this hose doesn't get kinked up anywhere. Okay, so I'm going to pull this pressure relief valve open, and I'm going to hold it up. And what happened is the light turned yellow. That means this unit tripped. So this simulates roughly a 5 psi per second increase for roughly a half of a second, and the unit tripped, which is what it's supposed to do. So this is a good unit. That's kind of the pass test. There's also a fail test where you run the pressure up to a lower pressure. It's all in the table, and you really should wait 60 seconds in between the tests. So if you want, you can set the timer. For time's sake, I'm not going to reset the timer, because while I'm talking, this time is going to be going on. So our no-go test for a 900 unit tells us to go between 1.25 and 1.5 PSA. So I'm a little under 1.5 PSA. And the needle looks like it's stabilized. If you start losing pressure, the best thing to do is start checking a lot of these fittings to make sure there's everything's connected good. Typically this bushing might have to be tightened down. It looks like I'm holding pressure just fine. So I'm going to reset the timer. What this is going to simulate is a slow rate of rise. And what we want to have happen is when we relieve the pressure this time, we don't want that yellow light to trip. Okay, this would simulate a false trip on a transformer. And this simulates, like I said, simulates a low rate of pressure rise. This test kit also has a power down timer. So in the course of your testing, if all of a sudden you don't have any lights, I think it's about a 5 or 6, 7 minute timer where it actually powers down from the batteries to the circuit board. In that case, you'd have to repress this button to power it back up. Right now I'm just waiting for the red light to come on, which says that 60 second delay has been done, which happened. So I'm going to do the same thing, make sure there's no kinks. I'm going to relieve the pressure, and I do not want that yellow light to trip. Same scenario, you hold it up, it didn't trip. So this tells me with pretty good confidence this unit is calibrated within specifications. Okay. And you just disassemble everything that you assemble, and you're all set to go. The unit will power down within, I think it's 5 to 7 minutes, something like that. Replace your vent.
Put the pipe
dope. That's what we have. We have pipe dope to put back on this vent. And that's basically it.